class 1 EVS worksheets on animals around us. First worksheet is on matching. Here kids need to match the animals with their sound. Like they need to match crow with caws, then monkey with chatters. Next is dog. So they need to match dog with barks, hen with clucks. Next is duck. So they need to match duck with quacks, then lion with roars, cow with moos, and at last they need to match cat with mew. For the first part, kids need to write two examples for each question. Like first one is birds that swim. So here two examples are duck and penguin. Next is very large animals. So for this, kids can write elephant and rhinoceros. Third one is birds that do not fly. So here examples are penguin and ostrich. And the fourth one is domestic animals. Examples are cow and goat. Next is true or false statement. First question, a cow is a wild animal. Answer is false. Next one, we find fish in rivers. That is true. Third one, the goat is a domestic animal. This one is also true. Next is, we see giraffes and rhinoceros around our homes. False. Question number 5. The blue whale is the biggest animal in the world. That is true. For the next question, kids need to find the names of animals and birds from the given word grid. Like cow, lion, cat, deer, elephant, tiger, duck, giraffe, cheetah, hen, whale, and rhinoceros. Next question is odd one out. Here, kids need to circle the odd one and also they need to write the reason for that. Like, first question is fox, cat, and zebra. Here, odd one is cat because cat is a pet animal but others are wild animals. Next set is crow, sparrow, and ostrich. Here, odd one is ostrich because ostrich is a bird that cannot fly, but others are birds that can fly. Next question is fill in the blanks. First one, cows and goats are, answer is domestic animals. Next one, wild animals live in forests and open lands. Third question, dogs are kept at home as pet. Next question, birds have wings. These help them fly. Here, kids need to put a tick mark beside the statement that we should do when we see an animal or have one at home. Like, first statement is throw a stone or stick at a garden lizard, bird, or dog. This is a very bad thing and we should not do that. Second statement is place a bowl of water outside for animals and birds in summer. This is a very good habit, so we need to put a tick mark beside this sentence. Third one, tie up your pet dog all day. We should not do that. Fourth one, pat your pet and brush its coat every day. We need to put a tick mark beside this statement because we should take care of our pets. Next is take your dog for a walk often. This is also good. So we need to put a tick mark beside this. Sixth statement, grow flowering plants to attract butterflies. Also good. And the last one is tease animals. That is very bad. We should not do that. Next is question and answers. First question is, give two ways to take care of animals. So here, kids can write, two ways to take care of animals are to give them food, water and shelter. And another way is to treat them when they are sick. For the next question, kids need to draw and label one wild animal and one pet animal of their choice. That's all for now. Thanks for watching Kids A to Z.